Hello everyone, welcome to the Didymy IAS platform. So as you all know, today has been a great day because GS paper 1 has been completed and the GS paper 2 is also going on right now. And I'm recording this video for you people to discuss the history kind of questions that were asked and what were the difficulty levels and what are the possible solutions for it. And what are the sources that he has probably lifted these questions from and how would you answer it or eliminate the options as such. So quickly getting into that discussion, I'll share the PPT with you for the questions. So here comes your discussion on the prelims question paper history analysis. So let's get started with the first thing. First question that was like, I was doing this set of the paper. So this is the order of the questions that were there in. Just see the questions with irrespective of the question number. Okay. So the first thing is Halbi, Ho, and Kui are related to what? So Ho is a kind of a tribe. Even if you didn't know these both of the things, Ho, Munda, on all these are of, you know, Indo-Australian type of even in geography as such, and even in your art and culture, you would be coming across Ho and Munda tribes. So it is definitely should be related, something related to the tribes, and which most, you know, very, very distinct and very nearby, it has to be referred. If you even didn't know any of the possible solution to it, you should definitely come down, boil down your options to the option A and B. As I told you, Ho and Munda are the tribes. Definitely it will be tribal related to some tribal languages. This is the option answer. The next question is songs from the prison. And one person has translated into English, lyrics into English. So, but the translation has been done. Okay, fine. So how would you boil down these options to? One thing is that Jawaharlal Nehru discovery of India were about much more sophisticated poems. It was about giving an instance of insight into what India's struggle is all about and all these things. Definitely it's not something related to the religious lyrics. Okay, religious lyrics, definitely not. Sarojini Naidu, she was all obviously put into bars, behind bars many times, but as such, there is no distinctive evidence of that. Whereas Tilak and Gandhiji have been the most frequent members. So obviously you should be confused in these two options. Whereas Tilak is more relevant with the Valentine Kirols, the kind of instances that he was using through his writings and all that were most related to the outside, where he even went to fight a case against few people outside India. So he is nowhere related to the religious aspect of the lyrics. Okay. So most importantly, if you have to think about this option, these two options, even if you don't know, because there is no direct evidence from, usually you read it from the spectrum where you can directly refer that, you know, this particular songs from prison is mentioned there. No, it is not mentioned, but you have to understand this is what the applied form of the questions that have been asked. So this is directly M.K. Gandhi, which is a direct thing that you can easily identify from this option. I would term this as an easy one because Ho and most of you would be able to be comfortably doing this question. This is also applied part, somewhat a medium level of difficulty, maybe you can assign it to. Here when you come, the other two forms of the something names that are mentioned, which is not of importance. What is important is Bhavabhuti. He's a very, very important kind of a playwrightist who is always equated with the Kalidasa. So Bhavabhuti is also mentioned in your Tamil Nadu NCERT book, the part one book that he's also mentioned. And if you read out any of your sources, not spectrum, I would say, because spectrum is modern India. And as such, even your NCERTs, not apart from the NCERTs, if you take any of the history, synoptic magazines or anything, Bhavabhuti is mentioned everywhere. Bhavabhuti is mentioned everywhere, and listening to the Bhavabhuti itself, you need to know that it is something related to somebody who writes like Kalidasa. So it is playwrights. Okay. Next thing, I would say this is also a direct question because Bhavabhuti is very famous personality, playwrights. Next, the 56th question, whenever you see without even going through all of the question, here itself you can find Bethune Female School. This is a direct thing lifted from the spectrum book itself. Your spectrum, please get back after you finish your examination and see through it. You will find this Bethune Female School has been established and he has been becoming the secretary. He is none other than Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar. It's a very direct question. There is no sense of lot of things or things to be understood to it. This again, I would say it's a very logical enough that, you know, 1919 was a very kind of a stick that was thrown at the people of India. So why would they even grant some women rights for us, right? So for that purpose, what you have to think is the 1999, the Montagu Chelmsford reforms, this is not providing anything, because if you remember in 1919, what was happening, how Gandhiji has been, you know, relentlessly fighting for all of these things. There was a Rowlatt Act and all of these things are happening. So that is not a conducive environment for some kind of reforms to be happening. Whereas 1935 has recognized, definitely 1935, whose many of the percepts are being even used now in the constitution. So definitely this is the thing, not this one. So the option is only two is right. Well, coming to the 55, this is also direct. This is like, even if you have read your polity, first chapter, history of the constitution making, you can definitely do it. Next, this question is about, it's a very simple thing that Paragana's will definitely come in the end. Paragana's are the district-wise units that will be coming at the administrative ends. Where does that form? This obviously forms at the C option. That is like, even if you don't know Subha and Sarkar's, Paragana's is something that you have to definitely know. That is the last of the units. So here again, this instant is available in Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu books, it has already been mentioned. And when we have taken the history classes also, one of the PPT slides have also mentioned this hierarchy. Like every dynasty has this hierarchy of administrative units. So this is the answer for this question. 8 August of 1942, the moment you say it is nothing but the AICC has adopted the resolution of Quit India. That's it. There is no other thing that should come into mind, taking this date into mind, because Spectrum has it. And as such, also 1942 is a most phenomenal. In August, mein jo bhi hua tha, it's a phenomenal activity that has happened in the freedom struggle. So it is 8th August. Next is 57th question. All of these people, Prem, Gurbakhshan Singh, Nilon, obviously these have been openly hanged, and many things were going on when people have come to fight for them at the Red Fort. So this is a very direct. This I don't think anybody of you would have even wasted 2 seconds of your time also in marking the answer. And next question, this is an interesting question, because third option may probably you must have faltered, like Rohilkhand Kingdom, is it Durrani or not? Definitely Durrani is a very important person. But Durrani is a dynasty that is related to the Afghanistan Wali area, and the Rohilkhand Kingdom is nothing to do with this person. Rohilkhand Kingdom is much to do with the Ali Muhammad Khan. Ali Muhammad Khan was the person that was related to it. I would say this is somewhat difficulty only. This option completely, unless you know that person, otherwise you will easily fall into the trap of Ahmad Shah Durrani. Either you will fall into the trap of marking it right, or you would not attempt this question, right? In that sense. So this is wrong. If you eliminate the third option, you will be left with either. So two option is definitely right. That is for sure. Okay, two option is definitely right. So you need to know whether one is right or not. Nizam of Arcot, he has been a subsidiary of these Hyderabad state, and that's how he has arisen out of it. Definitely this is the right option. So answer is 1 and 2. Right. So next thing is, with reference to the Chaucer Yogini Temple, the recent why this topic has been lifted from history portion is because of our parliament being, reframed, like how it has to be made and all that. For that purpose, this question was lifted. That is what I time and again emphasize upon you people, that UPSC does lift up questions that are related to current affairs, but it will link you somewhere through geography, environment, anything. So the first thing is correct. The dynasty is right, circular term and all that. It is the only, so this is an extreme statement, so leave it aside. Vaishnavai cult, no, the goddess Devi is meant, Yogini. It's a female form of a god that is mentioned. Vaishnava cult is just not. And the fourth one, yes, parliament building has been inspired from this. So the answer to this, this thing is 1 and 4 is the options, is the right answer to this. Next question, Ajanta River, yes, Waghur River. It is Waghur. It is not Waghura, Waghur River actually, like more on a same similar. Sanchi Stupa comes to the south part is drained by Bitwa River, not the Chambal River. And whereas once you know this option, obviously you will go. Otherwise, if you want to eliminate, Amaravati is in Krishna, not the Godavari. And here also, it's not the Narmada River, it is there in the Nasik area. So why will Narmada River flow into that area, right? Pretty fine, right? This is the logic. So the answer is A. Next question, water harvesting structure. C. For water to get harvested and reservoirs to be constructed, you need to have a good sense of water to be flown in that area. It can never be the Kalibangan or the Rakhigad area, because it is that area, these two places are not being drained by the major river system. So the answer should definitely be in Dholavara or Ropar, Punjab region or the Gujarat region. The reservoir system, significant reservoir systems have been mentioned in Dholavara. So the answer to this question is option A. Next question is about the factors that have been established by the East India Company. But remember, the first quarter of 17th century, which is like 1600, say 1650. Majorly, it was like Surat, it was Masulipatnam, Broach was also there. Major ones only was established. Chikakol, which is also the Chikakulam near to the Odisha coast, was later established. Trichinopoly or the Kerala coast, and after that, Kochi and everything, after that, Trichinopoly was established as this thing. So I would say these have come later on period. So Broach will definitely form. So answer is only one. Next question, Madanapalli. This I would term as a difficulty level. It is difficult because I belong to the state, so I would definitely refer to this place. Instantly, I can tell that, you know, Rabindranath Tagore has penned down this something. I can talk about it. But for people, somebody outside the state of this state, and no, not much references have been coming for this referring to any of your the standard sources, I wouldn't say it is that easy for you, anybody to even write it on all that. There is this book called as Krishna Reddy, who is an author of from the Telangana state. He, in his book, it has been mentioned. So that that's why I say that, you know, even in our classes, I've said that if you can finish it off your NCERTs and then give a good just an overview reading of Krishna Reddy to not let you miss out on any other fact, that would have been helped here, I would say. But this is the answer. This is not the answer for this last option is Adyar. It is in Chennai. So this is not the option. And Pattabhi Sitaramai didn't read it from the Madanapalli. And Pingal Venkaya also has not been. And this Madanapalli is also famous for the hand symbol. Okay. In the INC ka jo hand symbol abhi जो बना था यही पे बना हुआ था राइट. नेक्स्ट दिस क्वेश्चन में देखोगे तो चंद्र केतुघर इज इन बंगाल टेराकोटा. यस दिस इज अ पीरियड. दिस इज बेसिकली इट इज कमिंग फ्रॉम पेलियोलिथिक नियोलिथिक एंड चालकोलिथिक. उस वाले फेजेस में दिस चैप्टर कम्स इन. सो ज्ञानेश्वर इज कॉपर आर्टिफैक्ट्स बिकॉज कॉपर एज कम्स later point of time in Maharashtra, where the ages, if you see, they have settled from the north to the central India portion. So copper definitely comes in the later part of time. This is also right. This is right. But Burzahom is a Neolithic site where pottery is more famous rather than the rock cut shrines and anything. So that's why the option to this, I would say 2 and 3. And now again, here in this question, the third option, guys, this is something we have already discussed in our history sessions also. It is not Devaraya II. It is Immadi. Okay. Immadi Narasimha is the person who was available in the Vijayanagara Empire when the Vasco da Gama has arrived. So this is the option wrong. When you eliminate these two options, you definitely know one is the right option. So don't even read out the first option because we don't have time. I see in today's paper, current affairs were also mentioned, and you will not have so much time to, you know, think about and ponder about it. Just try eliminating options, and so that you will not have the need of reading the first statement as such here. When you know third option is wrong, eliminate these two. You already know one is all common in both the options. What is the second option? Second option, it is not Mohammad bin Tughlaq. It is Muhammad Shah Tughlaq, on whose during whose tenure this time war has occupied. So this is also wrong. So what forms the answer? Only one forms the answer. Next, the Mitakshari. Regarding this option, guys, there is some a kind of confusion. Confusion in the sense that it was not explicitly mentioned anywhere that Mitakshari relates to what and all that. Whereas these two options are obviously for this question, I would say this is very difficult. Very difficult because all of us know that Mitakshari was leading to some ancestral property about the land rights and these hereditary rights and all that. Whereas Mitakshari says that, you know, definitely when you that it is only related to the male members of the family, whereas Dayabhaga says that Daya means it will have some kind of, you know, think about this. Daya has a giving importance to both males and females. Yes, it deals about the male and the women also having a share about it. Like Shridhan, jaise wo bahar jaati hai, shadi hote, she will get a share as Shridhan. That is also there. So this is right. The third option is absolutely right. So third option has to be there somehow. So the one and two, if we try to eliminate, the first option is still, it was not explicitly mentioned anywhere, guys. So I'm not able to reveal you the answer as such. Probably I will update you in our Didymi IAS channel regarding this option after a quiet research, because this I would term either you leave it or you have to take a calculated risk in this question. Next question is this again, I would say This is another difficulty level because we don't have any direct influences of Perth. Yes, St. Francis, along with seven members, some people have come to India, settled at Goa, trying to propagate the Christianity and all this. Yes, he's one of the founding members, but he has expired in China because he was on a mission to convert China into a Christian land. So he died at China, not in India. Next feast is celebrated everywhere in Goa. So the option is 1 and 3. Anyways, if you just know that, you know, he didn't die in India, so then you can easily eliminate the option 2, and the answer is 1 and 3. Most of the students, what they will do is that checking all the options, they will definitely see the second option is nowhere related. Okay, in the sense, so second option is a common one for the next three options. So eliminating it, 1 and 3 will be the answer. That way also you can take some calculated risk. And the 60th question of that paper, 21st February, yes, definitely is a mother language day. But guys, it is not by UNICEF. UNICEF is for the emergency funding or, you know, kind of programs that it does for the rehabilitation. UNICEF always, you hear it out for the African continent or something like that. Why will that declare some national language? Right, the Mother Language International Day. It is by UNESCO, not UNICEF. This is a trap that UPSC tried to play. So the first option is wrong. 21st February is right, but it is by UNESCO, not UNICEF. Next, demand of Bangla. Yes, what happened was after the partition, we had these West Pakistan and East Pakistan, right? So West Pakistan and East Pakistan, like Bangladesh was also included in Pakistan at that point of time. So East Pakistan ke jo bhi log the, they also tried to, you know, place a formula into the constitution and simply asking for a language for the Bangla people also, but it was not accepted. But only Urdu was accepted at that point of time. This is right. This is absolutely right. So the answer to this is second statement is correct. So this forms your like overall questions that have been asked. Around 20 questions have been asked, which can be directly, you know, related to the sense of history. So I hope I have made it clear. And timely, if I can, you know, take up any other queries, we'll be happy to help you always. You can just comment or you can always try asking other queries also. I hope you have done great with your GS1 paper and hopefully you're doing well with your GS paper, the CSAT paper also, paper 2 of today's session. All the best, guys. Hopefully, start your mains preparation irrespective of your querying into the list or not, because the cycle has to just get completed. All the best.